Hello, I'm Sebastian. Welcome to Nine Gnar Trees podcast. Today, I will summarize and review the book. Merchants of Doubt is a compelling and thought-provoking book authored by Naomi Oreskes that delves into the insidious tactics employed by a select group of scientists and industry representatives who have systematically undermined public understanding of critical scientific issues. Oreskes brings to light the parallels between the campaigns against smoking and the denial of climate change, revealing how corporate interests leverage skepticism to obscure the truth and influence public policy. This book serves as a vital examination of the interplay between science, media, and politics, illustrating how misinformation can cloud important debates that impact the world. Through meticulous research and a gripping narrative, Oreskes documents the strategies used by these merchants of doubt to mislead the public, challenging readers to confront the repercussions of allowing scientific discourse to be swayed by manipulation and propaganda. The importance of this book lies not only in its historical accounts, but also in its urgent relevance to contemporary conversations about science and society. In an era marked by misinformation and distrust in expert opinions, Merchants of Doubt is an essential read for anyone interested in understanding the challenges facing legitimate scientific discourse and the necessity of safeguarding the integrity of science in the public sphere. I will give you key takeaways from this book. Firstly, the role of industry in misinformation. Oreskes illustrates how various industries, most notably tobacco, have historically employed a range of tactics to generate doubt about scientific consensus. With a focus on tobacco companies, she explores how these entities funded research that produced ambiguous outcomes, thereby creating confusion about the health risks associated with smoking. This strategy of promoting uncertainty was not limited to tobacco. It has been adopted by industries including fossil fuels and chemical manufacturing, where corporate interests clashed with public health and environmental stewardship. Oreskes demonstrates that the techniques used by these industries often included hiring scientists to refute established findings, engaging in public relations campaigns aimed at disseminating doubt, and manipulating the media narrative to align with corporate interests. By delving into specific case studies, the book reveals how these actions have consequences beyond the researchers involved, effectively shaping public perception and policy decisions over decades. This exploration underscores the necessity of ethical responsibilities in scientific research and the potential dangers posed by allowing industry interests to dictate the conversation surrounding scientific truths. Moreover, it leads to a broader understanding of how similar mechanisms can operate in current debates about climate change and other pressing social issues. Secondly, the science of climate change and its denial. In Merchants of Doubt, Oreskes provides an in-depth analysis of climate change science and the deliberate strategies employed by its deniers. By dissecting the consensus among climate scientists regarding human-induced global warming, she highlights how a small group of skeptics has worked tirelessly to create a false narrative suggesting significant doubt about climate changing. This narrative serves the interests of fossil fuel corporations and their allies, who seek to preserve the status quo of profit over planet. Oreskes documents instances where scientific findings were deliberately misrepresented to suggest an equivalence between peers who favor action on climate change and those who dispute it. The chapter on climate denial resonates deeply as it reveals how ideology and financial considerations can corrupt scientific inquiry and stifle necessary discourse on issues critical to humanity's future. The strategies of climate denialists are shown not only to undermine scientific consensus, but to threaten international efforts aimed at mitigation. Ultimately, this section serves as a wake-up call, illustrating the high stakes involved when misinformation proliferates, and it emphasizes the moral obligation for scientists to maintain transparency and integrity in their work. Thirdly, the media's role in the scientific debate. Oreskes highlights the media's critical role in shaping public perception of scientific issues. By examining how media outlets often present opposing viewpoints in a manner that suggests an equal standing, she calls into question the practice of false balance in journalism. This phenomenon occurs when media coverage emphasizes the opinions of a small number of dissenting voices over the overwhelming consensus of the scientific community. Oreskes illustrates how this practice can lead to public confusion and misunderstandings about issues like climate change and public health. By analyzing case studies, she emphasizes that journalists, tasked with disseminating accurate information to the public, must be held accountable in their reporting. The book argues for a more responsible and informed approach to media coverage of science, advocating for a reliance on expert consensus rather than a misguided attempt at even-handedness. Oreskes asserts that the media's failure to properly contextualize scientific information contributes to triggering episodes of intense public skepticism toward well-established facts. Thus, the chapter becomes an important commentary on the intersection of media, politics, and science in modern society, urging both journalists and consumers of news to be rigorous and critical about the information they encounter. Fourthly, the psychological and political dimensions of denial. The book delves into the psychological factors that contribute to public denial of scientific consensus, particularly issues related to identity, belief systems, and cognitive dissonance. Oreskes discusses how polarized political beliefs can affect an individual's acceptance of scientific evidence. Many people may reject climate change science not merely due to lack of information, but because acknowledging it conflicts with their political ideology or deeply held beliefs. This section of the book explains how scientific denial can serve a psychological function, allowing individuals to maintain their worldview in the face of uncomfortable truths. Oreskes also connects this phenomenon to broader political movements that manufacture dissent and debate topics that should have already reached consensus. The psychological and political dimensions of skepticism draw a complex picture of how social factors influence the understanding and acceptance of science. By understanding these dynamics, the reader is invited to consider the ways economic, political, and educational systems can be reformed to foster a healthier relationship with science. This section ultimately encourages a paradigm shift toward greater scientific literacy and open dialogue about contentious issues. Lastly, confronting the challenge of misinformation, Oreskes concludes her analysis with a call to action for readers to engage with the pressing challenge of misinformation and the role each of us plays in combating it. She emphasizes the importance of educating oneself about scientific issues and critically evaluating the sources of information one encounters. In a world where misinformation is rampant, Oreskes argues that individual action is vital for promoting a well-informed public. This section underscores the need for transparency in scientific communication and advocates for policies that ensure scientific literacy among citizens. Oreskes also highlights the responsibility of scientists to communicate their findings in accessible and engaging ways. The fight against misinformation requires collaboration among various stakeholders, including educators, scientists, and the media. By fostering a culture that values evidence-based inquiry and critical thinking, Oreskes envisions a society better equipped to confront the challenges posed by misinformation and to advocate for science-informed policies. This portion of the book serves as an empowering message, reminding each reader of their potential to affect change within the community and beyond. In conclusion, Merchants of Doubt is an essential read for anyone concerned about the intersection of science, policy, and public opinion. The book is particularly relevant for students, educators, policymakers, journalists, and citizens who want to understand the anatomy of misinformation and its impact on serious issues such as climate change and public health. Oreskes meticulously outlines the mechanisms of doubt that certain industries have used to obstruct progress, drawing from historical case studies that resonate with contemporary challenges we face today. For individuals seeking to become more informed citizens, the book provides valuable insights into the importance of supporting rigorous scientific inquiry and defending against manipulation. Moreover, its exploration of the role of media and psychology in shaping scientifically informed discourse encourages readers to think critically about the information they digest daily. In an age when noise is ubiquitous, understanding how to sift through misinformation becomes a life skill that empowers one to participate meaningfully in democratic discourse. Overall, Merchants of Doubt equips readers with the knowledge they need to navigate a complex maze of information, understand the stakes involved in scientific debates, and ultimately contribute to a more informed society that values evidence over ideology. Reading this book can profoundly change the way you engage with scientific issues, preparing you to take a stand against misinformation and advocate for rational discourse in your community. If you would like to support Naomi Oreskes, you can buy the book through the Amazon link I've provided in the podcast description. After reading the book, please let me know what you think and share your thoughts. See you around.